but good. I'm welcome. Super excited to have you here. Huge shout out to AMD for sending me so many 9800X3Ds to be able to do as many builds as you guys want. Kicking it off for the CPU, we're using the AMD Ryzen 7 9800X3D. Pretty much the hottest CPU on the planet right now. Impossible to get, sells out all the time. Really, really, really good CPU. And like probably the one that's got everybody excited because it's actually a good CPU. We're gonna be using a 2 terabyte Samsung 980 Pro. It's pretty much the cheapest, best performing NVMe drive that is on sale right now. For the RAM, I got this at a really good deal. You could save some money here. This is 32 gigs of 6400 mega transfer DDR5 from G-Skill. This is Triton Z5 Neo. If you wanted to go and save yourself about 30 bucks, you could do that by going down to just a regular Z5 kit at 6,000. For the motherboard, we're using the B650 Plus Wi-Fi. This is $179.99. There is actually a less expensive version that you could do for this motherboard. You could do the B650-E from ASUS Wi-Fi. It's $149.99. There's also the MSI Pro, which is the Pro-P, which is $149.99. And then there's a $129.99 B650, the Gigabyte Eagle, which is another option as well. For cooling, we're going dirt cheap, guys. Dirt cheap, but not performance cheap. The Thermalright Phantom Spirit 120 SE, this is the ARGB version. I just wanna let you guys know, the difference between this ARGB and the non-ARGB is less than a dollar. So I don't know what the performance difference is because I haven't tested it, but still, a buck more for more lights seems like a nice bonus. So anyway, you can get this and get this down to the 120 SE and basically and do the non-ARGB version. GPU, ASUS Tough RTX 4070 Super. If you wanted to save money and get a less expensive 4070 Super, MSI Gaming X Trio Slim, you can get it for about $100 less right now. I think it's $569 for that. For our power supply, surprise, surprise, the MSI Tough Gaming 850 watt. You could go down to the 750 watt. I think it's $104 or $105 for that one. But the good thing about this is that the cables are nice. It's easy to basically make them look pretty so you don't need cable extensions. And people are actually usually pretty impressed when we do this. So, all right, so let's go and get this going. Starting with our MOBO. $98, she says. $95.8 on the first one. $95.8. 3, 2, 1. $94. Neither one of those, guys. Sorry, it was not a good click today. They should be up in the next couple weeks. There we go, covering up our AMD 9800X3D. By the way, I'm gonna remember the peel down here. Now, one thing I will always say, guys, when you're gonna do one of these air coolers, make sure you have an appropriately sized screwdriver, just in case, you know? Just wanna make sure that you can get down there without any problem. Okay, we're good there. Got everything ready for that. It is hefty. Like, this thing is not light. It feels super solid for like what is essentially 90 bucks. Yeah, the case itself is really nice. The PSU goes in kind of a weird spot. This in here. Oh, that is a small. There we go. And that is like just enough room for that build. Next one is our 12 volt or 16 pin. And then we've got our, boom, love it. Okay. Interesting having to worry about that. You definitely gotta be smart about the cables in the back. Okay, there we go. Okay, so there's your PSU hooked up. Now, the one thing that you do have to be cognizant of, so when you place your PSU in, if you're gonna place it last, these cables here, if they're too tight, you will not be able to slip your PSU in. So this and this can actually make it harder for your PSU. Luckily, I had a lot of cable room here. So this is just something to be aware of. If you're gonna be last, make sure that you've got the room. So usually that's something you worry about down over here in the corner. Like if you don't do good cable management, you might have a hard time sliding in, but because of how this PSU comes in, it's just a little bit different in that regard. Nicely tie in, get our power in. There we go. Hey! There it goes. Here's where we're gonna see. Can you air cool a 9800X3D? Here it is, 3 minutes in, it's not going anywhere. It's just sticking at 82. So no problem whatsoever there. So let's stop that. Okay, so let's load this up. So now we'll see our GPU temps and CPU temps. Video, full screen. Oh, we don't want, what the deuce? 4K, thank you, no. Okay, so let's do ray tracing ultra. DLSS, one auto, we'll leave frame generation off. I don't know why it's even on. Frame gen off, texture quality. Actually, let's do, DLSS. on balanced. Okay. Oops, we don't care about that. Run benchmark. Oh, I have no issue with frame generation. I just want to show you how it's meant to be played, what the performance is going to be like, and at the same time, you can see CPU temps and GPU temps, which CPU temp right now is 71, GPU sitting at a very nice and frosty 52 degrees, and we are getting 88 frames per second. Getting a very nice and easy 85, 86 frames per second right there. CPU temp sitting nice and frosty at 55 degrees. Yeah, the man with the carrots keeping it cool. And there you go, average frame rate 91.22. Like, not, our CPU was never above 60. So there you go, guys. There is some gaming performance, some just regular standard performance, and a nice $1,800 9800X3D build. It's gonna be super, super awesome, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in today. Have an absolutely, absolutely amazing rest of your day. Bye, guys.